So next we are going to discuss about principle of flotation. Okay, so principle of flotation. It's an important topic, okay, and there is a very important observations which you are going to take after discussing this topic. Okay, so first, what is mean by this principle of flotation? Suppose if a body is there, let me take any body, okay, it's a solid body. So this solid body, we take any body, any solid body. This solid body is wants to, like I need to make this solid body to float in a liquid. Okay, let me take the liquid's density is rho f. Okay, this is the free surface. So I want this solid body to float in the liquid. So if the solid body has to float in the liquid, what are all the conditions? What are all the conditions for the solid body to float? So first thing, it is a static fluid. If it is a static fluid, there won't be any shear. There will be only pressure. So due to that pressure, there will be, due to the pressure difference, there will be an upward force, buoyancy force, which is going to act at the center of buoyancy. Okay, we already know. And buoyancy force is nothing but weight of the fluid which is getting displaced, right? So that is acting at the center of buoyancy. Center of buoyancy is nothing but centroid of the submerged body. So centroid of this submerged body is center of buoyancy, and buoyancy force is acting at center of buoyancy. And now, what are the other forces? Now we will think about the forces. What are the other forces on this body? Okay, not only the force the fluid is going to offer on the body, the force of the body. So there will be another force, right? What will be that another force? That will be the gravity force, and nothing but weight of the body itself. Okay, weight of the body itself, WB, and we know that this WB will be acting at the center of gravity, right? Now, when can I say that this body is going to float? Only if the buoyancy force which is acting upward equals to the weight of the body which is acting downward. If the weight of the body and buoyancy force are not same, then for instance, if weight of the body is more, if weight of the body is more than that of buoyancy force, then this will start to move downward because the net downward force will be more. Weight is more compared to buoyancy force, so this body will start to move downward. Or else if buoyancy force is more than that of weight, what will happen? This body will start to move upward, right? So both are not the condition for flotation. If a body has to float, then weight and buoyancy force should be same. Moreover, both this weight and buoyancy force should act in the same line of action. That is very, 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 very important. It should be acting in the same line of action, because if both this buoyancy force and weight of the body is not in the same line of action, for instance, body weight is this, okay, weight of the body, and buoyancy force is acting here. So what will happen? There will be a consequence of moment, right? So this is not going to be stationary, it will start to rotate. Okay, so the consequence of moment, if center of buoyancy shifts away from center of, like the line of action of center of gravity, what is going to happen? Those things we will discuss further. But if it has to float, then both of them has to lie in the same line. Regarding that is, if the buoyancy force shift right side or shift left side, then what will happen? Those things we will discuss further in equilibrium, okay, in equilibrium condition. So if it has to float and there should not be any external moment also. The first condition was weight of the body, okay, so weight of the body should be equal to buoyancy force itself. That is, FB will be equal to WB. And what is WB, weight of the body, in the sense, let me take density of the body to be rho B, okay, volume of the body to be VB. Rho B is density of the solid body, and VB is volume of the solid body. Then how can I write weight of the body? We know that weight density, rho G is equal to weight by volume. Right, so weight can be written as rho g into volume. Since I am finding weight of the body, the weight of the body will be equal to rho b g into vb. Fb should be equal to rho b g into vb. Okay, so that is the condition for flotation. And what is the next condition? And fb and wb should lie in the same line of action. Okay, right. So next, this is the condition for flotation only. If the body has to float, then this should be satisfied. And this is not always true. Always, there is no guarantee that always weight of the body will be equal to buoyancy force, like buoyancy force is acting. It's a condition only for flotation. Now we will discuss in general, okay, in general, fully, like from the beginning, whatever we started, and now we came to one conclusion, right? I will combine both and I will give you some standard results, and those are very important for solving the problems. Okay, listen. So first, from Archimedes principle, what we got? Buoyancy force equals to weight of the fluid displaced, and the buoyancy, weight of the fluid displaced, is nothing but rho fg into vfd, right? So from Archimedes principle, this is what we got. Buoyancy force will be always equal to weight of the fluid displaced, and buoyancy force will be always acting upward. And the same Archimedes principle also says, I will write it here, volume of the fluid which is displaced is equal to volume of the body submerged. Okay, if the total body is submerged, then the total body is submerged, then volume of the fluid displaced will be total body. If it is submerged partially, then it will be partially. It, this first condition, that is the Archimedes principle condition, it is applicable everywhere, which means floating body, even if the body is floating, for that also I can apply this. Even if the body is fully submerged, completely submerged inside. Okay, fully submerged in the sense the body is completely submerged, volume of fluid displaced will be equal to volume of the body itself. Okay, for both floating body and fully submerged body, this condition is applicable. Buoyancy force equal to rho fg into vfd, buoyancy force equal to weight of the fluid which is getting displaced. But if you see, for the floating body, we got one equation, buoyancy force equals to weight of the body. And from Archimedes principle, I know that buoyancy force equals to weight of the fluid displaced, and weight of the body is nothing but rho density of the body g volume of the body. This will be equal to rho f g volume of the fluid displaced, right? And this is from floating condition, this is from buoyancy force. So if the body is floating, then what I can do, I can write buoyancy force equals to weight of the body, which is equal to weight of the fluid which is getting displaced, and weight of the body is nothing but rho b, density of the body g into volume of the body. WFD means density of the fluid g into volume of the fluid, and this, that is the last one, this one only for floating body. Okay, so this is for all, this one, that is weight, buoyancy equals to weight of the body equals to weight of the fluid displaced, that is only for floating body. Okay, and volume of the fluid displaced equal to volume of the body submerged, that is applicable everywhere. So this is what you need to know. If you know this, most of the problems in buoyancy you can attack. Okay, and there are few other concepts which we need to discuss. We will proceed further.